And now, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and give a reaction to the action of the World Wrestling Empire!
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Silverado, and with me tonight is The Ledge. We have an incredible card for you tonight.
Awesome card coming up. First out of the shoot will be the Tennessee Rebel versus Predator in a little bit of a grudge match.
Second one's going to be my main man, Annihilator, going up against his arch nemesis, Scott Summers.
All right, and that'll be an awesome match. Both of those guys are former World Wrestling Empire heavyweight champions. And then for the main event tonight, the high-flying Shane Cortez takes on the likes of Texas Outlaw Dirty Dan Wilder.
I think Dirty Dan Wilder is going to teach Shane Cortez a little bit about Texas justice.
All right, well, all that and more coming up tonight on the World Wrestling Empire. We're going to take a short break for a commercial, and we'll be back with the first match.
JT Rocker, my man, when I came to the World Wrestling Empire, I was looking for talent, and I thought that you had it. I've gotten you title matches, I've gotten you matches with the champions. I've sacrificed my body to Renegade and Flame and Raymond for you, for no money, because I'm financially secure as it is. I was looking toward the future, but sir, you ain't got a future. And Devlin Blanchard is standing on his own. I don't need you anymore. I don't want you anymore. See this? This was a partnership. Baby, those days are over. I'm on my own.
We're back, ladies and gentlemen, and ready to start the night action. Let's take it to ringside and to the ledge.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, in our first match for the evening, standing 6 foot tall, weighing in at 240 pounds, from Singapore, Predator.
An incredible athlete, the Predator has shown time and time again why he is in top contention for the belts of the WWE. Accompanied to the ring by Flamin' Raymond. Predator and Renegade have been going through negotiations of tagging. And somewhere in the absence of Abhiraj Neesh, Flamin' Raymond is now leading the Predator to the ring.
The third man in the ring this evening, referee Steve Hartley. And now his opponent this evening, standing 6 foot tall, weighing in at 225 pounds from Nashville, Tennessee, one half of the Southern Express, ladies and gentlemen, the Tennessee Rebel.
There he is, Tennessee Tuxedo. Oh, that's Ledge. Sorry about that. There he is. Getting ready to get pounded into the mat, the Tennessee Rebel. Ready to take a beating in the Empire any week that he wrestles. Look at him coming out with that weapon. That flag back there.
You know, I was a little surprised there. A little earlier, we saw an interview with Devlin Blanchard. I can't believe he's done away with a JT Rocker. I can't quite understand. I didn't think Devlin Blanchard was the kind of man to be motivated by money.
Devlin Blanchard has finally come to his senses. And if you ask me, I think he has really made a wise business move by dumping that clown JT Rocker.
I tell you what,
if he wants more money, I can help him with more money.
Renegade, the tag team partner for Predator. They're both in the ring now, going after the Tennessee Rebel.
All right, yeah.
Clothesline with that rattan cane. Raymond's got something to say to referee Steve Hartley.
Renegade's got something to say to Tennessee Rebel.
I can't believe it. What's going on here? Referee Steve Hartley's got plenty to say. Meanwhile, Predator and Renegade are going to work on the Tennessee Rebel. I don't know what's going on.
That's the way it ought to be.
Both referees are over there having a little discussion with Predator and Renegade. It looks like they're ordering them out of the ring tonight. What's going on? Oh, the referees are unhappy with that. They don't like the tactics of Flame and Raven. Well, they're talking it over. I don't know what goes on. It looks like a disqualification.
They don't have to come out and prove anything today.
No indication from the ring of what's going on. The match never really officially started because the bell never rang. I don't know. Here we go. Oh, the referees have disqualified the match. They sent Predator back to the locker rooms. That's unbelievable.
That's the only way Tennessee Rebels go win a match.
These are exactly what I'm talking about, the kind of tactics that have been a problem here in the World Wrestling Empire. Flamin' Raymond and his bunch jumping out there and ruining it for everybody. You know, it's got to kind of make you wonder about what Devlin Blanchard's got going on. I know he's been chumming up to you or something here, Silverado.
All I've done is point the way to Money Trail, buddy, and he likes it.
Money Trail? What Money Trail?
That's right. Well, you'll just have to figure that out for yourself.
Well, I don't know what's going on right now. Silverado seems to have plans for us this evening. I hope this doesn't get in the way of some good action from the World Wrestling Empire. I'll tell you what, let's take a break right now for some commercials and get this sorted out so we can get this on with tonight. Flamin' Raymond and his bunch are up to no good this evening. This is the World Wrestling Empire. We're going to take a short break to our sponsors, and we're going to be right back with more action.
Coming to Sapulpa, Oklahoma, December 10th at 8 o'clock for a live TV taping. The WWE invades the National Guard Armory on Highway 66. Adults, $5. Kids under 12, $1. Our main event for the evening will be Shane Cortez versus the Predator in a one-of-a-kind dog collar chain match. That's for live TV taping December 10th, Sapulpa, Oklahoma, the National Guard Armory. Be there. Hi, this is The Ledge from the World Wrestling Empire reminding you to tune in next week, same channel, same time. Raging Cajun takes on light heavyweight champion Renegade for the title. Beast gets his shot against heavyweight champion TJ Steele for the title. Southern Express gets to take on the Texas Outlaws, who are the World Wrestling Empire Tag Team Champions, for the title. That's next week, Channel 9, Tulsa Cable. Be there.
All right, welcome back to the World Wrestling Empire. We've got some action coming up at some point tonight. I can't help but believe Flamin' Raymond's out to ruin it for everybody.
I've got a really great announcement, though. I'll let everybody know. The Empirical Committee, because of my introduction into management, has decided that I cannot commentate because of my biasness. So therefore, I have acquired a new commentator for the Empire,
so
who will be taking my place, and he is none other than the incredible, intelligent Devlin Blanchard.
I can't believe Devlin Blanchard would accept anything from me. What's
the only man that can fill my shoes in the World Wrestling Empire
shoes
is coming out here right now.
Anybody out here can fill your shoes.
Impressive, incredible.
I can't believe it.
Devlin Blanchard finally came to your senses. A great man. And I'm out of here.
Oh, great. So now I can't believe it. I thought you were an okay guy, and all of a sudden you're taking money from Silverado. What's going on? Well, I'll deal with you later. Right now, we got some wrestling coming up at you, so let's get started with that right now. Coming in first, a four-time former World Wrestling Empire heavyweight champion, standing 6 foot, 7 inches tall, weighing in at 322 pounds, from Los Angeles, California, Annihilator.
Oh!
McCoy. And now for the challenger himself, a former World Wrestling Empire heavyweight champion, standing 6'7" tall, weighing in at 215 pounds. You know him as one half of the tag team Southern Express from Mobile, Alabama, Scott Summers!
Thank you, Blackjack!
Scott Summers, one of the true gentlemen for the World Wrestling Empire. These guys always provide a great match. Scott in fine form, ready to go tonight. Quick into the ring, quick on his feet.
We might want to mention here, Ledge, that Annihilator is accompanied to the ring by Eliminator and the very financially gracious Silverado.
That's right. Eliminator, as everybody knows, is the new tag team partner for Annihilator. Together, they'll be Families Incorporated. There's the bell. Both men circle the ring. Collar and elbow tie up.
Do you have a handful of tights there?
Nah, I'm Scott Summers, wouldn't act like that. It's just good wrestling. Both men back at it again. Collar and elbow tight. Scott, jump. Oh, getting excited. Scott ducks it. Side leg takeover and Annihilator's into the ropes.
Some tights in there too, Ledge.
Well, I don't think those are the type of tactics that a fine gentleman like Scott Summers would employ. I would expect that out of somebody like Annihilator, though.
Now, Annihilator, I've had a whole change of opinion of Annihilator in the past couple of weeks.
Well, based on the dollar signs in your eyes, I would expect that. Both men in the corner now. Big chop by Annihilator. Another big chop. I felt that one all the way back here. Oh, Scott reverses it. He's tired of it. He goes back to work. Little give and take, so you can dish it out. Who can take it?
Why is the referee getting the man out of the corner?
Stomps Annihilator into the corner. Referee Doug McCoy backs him off. Scott Summers showing he didn't mean business tonight.
What a good role model for kids, kicking a man when he's down. I can't justify that. What's the matter with the referee here? The man's in the corner and you don't get him off?
Well, I think Scott Summers is just employing some of the tactics that Annihilator would use.
I haven't seen Annihilator do anything like that.
Well, not yet tonight, we haven't. Oh, big move to the midsection. Forearm to the back. Scott Summers goes to his knees. Nice knee to the face of Scott Summers, and he's a little dazed. Annihilator follows it up with the boot, picks up the leg of Scott Summers and goes to work on that hamstring.
When you're talking about 322 pounds of pressure behind those big boots.
Lots of meat. Annihilator still showing the effects of that beer and peanut butter diet that Flamin' Raymond had him on. I wonder if Silverado will continue that training regimen.
Hey, if it works, why change it?
Annihilator right now seems to be getting the worst end of the stick. Annihilator's busy complaining again about the tight pull.
I told you he was getting a man by the tights.
I just think it's something for Annihilator to complain about. Normally we recognize that as a stalling tactic on Annihilator's part. Collar and elbow tie-up. Scott pushes Annihilator into the ropes. Oh, big whip. Oh, both wrestlers off the ropes. Oh, Scott ducks it. Oh, and Annihilator ties up into the ropes. Misses the flip of Scott Summers.
That also shows you that Annihilator has not only size,
very astute ring savvy. Annihilator's smart enough to keep all of that moving until he figures out what Scott Summers is trying to set up, figures he can't counter it, and stops the move.
That shows his brains.
Very savvy ring experience by Annihilator, I will give you that.
Exactly. And of course, taking wise advice from the expertise of Silverado.
Yep. Interested in Scott Summers' tactics as this match progresses. He's obviously got some sort of a plan to wear Annihilator down. Annihilator in his usual fine complaining form.
Scott's wanting to get a test of strength. I think that's a test that he can't pass with a big man like Annihilator.
Yes, both wrestlers stepping in for the test of strength now. There they go, torquing it down. Oh, Scott Summers pushes Annihilator into the ring. Both men going to work. Oh, and Annihilator brings Scott Summers to his knees. Oh, follows it up with the boot to the chest.
I told you that was a test that he wouldn't be able to pass.
Oh, reaches in now. Sets him up. Big body slam.
Driving him through the mats.
Scott Summers, of course, weighs 250 pounds. That's a lot of weight moving into that ring. Annihilator follows it up with a couple of big moves, and the Scott Summers is in trouble. No doubt Scott is also suffering from the mysterious disappearance of Colonel Tom Parman. We haven't seen him at ringside for quite some time now. Still no word as to what's happened to that fine Southern gentleman.
I don't miss him a bit. I am a fine Southern gentleman, not Parman.
Well, anybody that I have to worry about anybody that would deal with Silverado. There can't be anything fine about that.
You notice that Annihilator's working diabolically and methodically against Scott Summers.
Oh, nice roll-up by Scott Summers, but Annihilator able to kick out. And then at ringside comes Tennessee Rebel with Goliath, the largest man in the World Wrestling Empire.
And what are they doing out here?
Probably here to keep an eye on Silverado and what is the Exterminator?
Eliminator.
Oh, okay.
Get it right, please.
Scott Summers looking for some support from the crowd now. Oh, nice flip. That right there really tears up that hamstring in that knee area.
Definitely would be
goes to work.
Hyperextension in there.
Eliminator. I asked about it. I was trying to figure it out.
Scott Summers locks in figure four on it.
All right, this is Scott's big finishing move. He can torque this down. This may be one of the few times we'll see Annihilator actually give up. This submission hold is almost impossible to break, but let it be known that Annihilator does have the upper body strength and able to cope in this situation. We'll see if he can take advantage of it. He's going to try to flip Scott over now. There he goes. Working it in.
Annihilator gets the reversal. What that does is reverse the pressure because Scott's knees are down against the mat with Annihilator's weight pushing down on him. So now Scott is in pain, losing agony, baby.
Exactly. Annihilator is really torquing it down on that hold. Oh, but Scott's able to get him on over. Annihilator gets to the ropes, and the referee orders the hold broken.
He doesn't appear to be making any effort to break it.
Scott's got a three count to break the hold. Clean break by the former World Wrestling Empire heavyweight champion, Scott Summers. Annihilator rolls out of the ring into his entourage. And right there is a good example of just how huge Goliath is. Annihilator came and hit him at the chin when he looked him in the eyes.
That might be an interesting confrontation.
An even 7 foot. No takers for Annihilator. Oh, and Scott Summers is outside the ring now going to work on Annihilator. Silverado and the Eliminator don't seem to be able to be of much assistance at this point.
That shows you what a clean wrestler Scott Summers is.
Scott's setting up. He's up on the top rope now. Setting it up. Annihilator still. Oh, Scott misses with the elbow drop.
That's what he gets for not letting Annihilator take the time to get back in the ring.
Scott trying to finish Annihilator off early with that flying elbow. And Annihilator's using those ropes to torque down a chokehold.
That wasn't a chokehold. That was a chin lock.
That was a chokehold, and that's why the referee ordered it broken. Annihilator with a big chop to the chest of Scott Summers. Scott appears to have the wind knocked out of him at this point.
Well, he came down from probably 8 or 10 feet in the air on that mat. That would definitely knock the wind out of him.
Big suplex, and Annihilator throws Scott Summers onto the mat.
Annihilator specializes in high impact moves. He's in for the pin. 1, 2.
Oh, nice move by Scott Summers. Able to reverse that. Gets that leg scissors around Annihilator's head, but Annihilator's able to get into the ropes, and the referee orders the hold broken.
Scott must be winded. He's taking his time getting back.
Must be coming to the pit. Oh, here we go again. Annihilator's trying to call timeout in professional wrestling. While it's a great stalling tactic, it is kind of ridiculous for him to expect us to believe that the referee's going to give him a timeout.
You know, Lynch, as much as I don't approve of Scott Summers' tactics there, you must point out that professional wrestling is the only sport where you are allowed to kick a man when he's down. And that part I do like.
Part of the brutality of the World Wrestling Empire. That's why the difference is obvious. Referee Doug McCoy counts Annihilator back into the ring. Annihilator quickly over to Scott Summers, pushes him into the turnbuckle. Sets him up with a couple of good blows to the midsection. A big arm to the back of Scott Summers' head.
He's right in front of Goliath. Do you think maybe Annihilator is sending Goliath a message?
I don't know. As of yet, I know of nobody making any efforts to wrestle Goliath.
Looks like Annihilator is hurt the lower part of the spine there. Annihilator taking his time. He's methodical.
Annihilator will get warned here about those closed fists. Referee Doug McCoy jumps in the middle. He's wanting to duke it out with Scott Summers. Oh, and Scott sets the referee up on the turnbuckle. They line it up, and here they go. They're going to slug it out.
Referee Doug McCoy is in his own
right jab by Scott Summers.
McCoy may get caught in the middle of something he ain't.
Oh, and it looks like a fist fight in the World Wrestling Empire. Go!
Why isn't Doug McCoy making him open up his fist there? Now Annihilator sits McCoy up on the ropes. Annihilator throwing the shots, gut shots. Boot kind of low to Annihilator.
The referee's orders the bell rung.
Scott Summers, that shows you what kind of man he is. The referee calls for the bell and Scott Summers will not let up.
The referee's ordered the bell rung. We'll get an indication from the ring. Oh, we got a double disqualification for the fist fight. Scott Summers is hit by Annihilator comes in with the leg drop.
That shows you the intelligence of Silverado. There's always a game plan.
Scott Summers is down in the middle of the ring. Both wrestlers have already been disqualified.
Summers should have left it well enough.
Annihilator reaches in with a chokehold. Eliminator is Jesse Rebel. To let the referees sort this out, maybe get security involved, get these guys broke out. That was a double disqualification by referee Doug McCoy. This is the World Wrestling Empire. I'm the Ledge with Devlin Blanchard. We're going to take a short pause for the cause. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
From the beginning of time, mankind has striven to double, redouble his power.
The board of WWE.
Serious machine has
stopped with the tech.
North America.
All right.
Let me tell you something.
Over the unit, 40.
Tennessee.
13.
Hey, what's happening to y'all tonight? Woo! I tell you what, dear Bubba. You've done bit the bullet now and done chewed the fat. Because you're getting up against Texas. Personal back. Collect myself. I'm putting you out of wrestling there, Bubba.
Sale with.
Yes, sir. I'm putting you down.
Percent off.
Hard. So you just went to
your
rocking chair and get your cane.
Values and fabulous.
You're going out of wrestling and you're going to be hurt there, Bubba. Get into one of them, what do they call them? Nursing homes. Yeah, that's what it is. So you just take your time and listen close because Texas is going to stomp you down. Woo! Yeah.
Maybe that's it.
All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the World Wrestling Empire. I'm the Ledge with my co-host, new co-host, Mr. Devlin Blanchard. I don't know how Silverado pulled that one. Another little bit of dirty business.
Money talks, Ledge. Money talks. If we just saw the interview with the Texas Outlaws one more time against the Southern Express, this time for the tag team titles. Winner Tennessee Rebel and Scott Summers going to get enough of the beating that Bone Crusher Bobby Burns and Dirty Dan Wilder have laid upon them. Speaking of the Outlaws, we're going to see Dirty Dan Wilder in action in just a second. We'll go up to the ring now and turn it over to the Ledge.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the World Wrestling Empire. The third man in the ring for this match, Mr. Doug McCoy. All right, coming in first, standing
6 foot tall, weighing in at 212 pounds. You know him as one half of the Texas Outlaws. Ladies and gentlemen, Dirty Dan Wilder.
I've had the opportunity to stand across the ring as manager against Dirty Dan Wilder and Bone Crusher Bobby Burns. And let me tell you, Dirty Dan is appropriate for this man. He is accompanied by his partner and co-champion, Bone Crusher Bobby Burns.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, his opponent this evening, standing 6 foot, 1 inch tall, weighing in at 213 pounds, from Henrietta, Oklahoma, ladies and gentlemen, the High Flying Shane Cortez.
Quite possibly the most popular man in the world wrestling empire, Shane Cortez, High Flying Aerial Artist. Of course, I could say the same for myself. Let's see how Cortez flies with his wings split courtesy of Dirty Dan Wilder.
Well, Shane Cortez is a fine athlete, and this is Dirty Dan Wilder. I expect this to be a really good match.
Of course, the presence of Bone Crusher Bobby Burns at ringside has got to play on the psyche of Mr. Cortez.
Definitely will be a factor in this match.
Referee Doug McCoy checking the boots of Cortez. I think that highly advisable, checking the tights there.
I can't believe Shane Cortez hasn't made some arrangements for somebody to be there at ringside to keep an eye on these guys. Dirty Dan Wilder taking a few moments to remove all that cowboy finery that he and his tag team partner, Bone Crusher Bobby Burns, are famous for.
This ought to be a really good match. Dirty Dan Wilder, more of a ground wrestler. Slow and methodical. Cortez, a high flyer. We ought to see the best of both worlds here. Cortez, of course, was a championship amateur wrestler in high school.
There's the bell. Both men circling the ring now. Collar and elbow tie-up. And Dirty Dan backs Shane Cortez into the ropes. Referee orders a hold broke, and it's a clean break by both wrestlers.
Of course it is. Of course Dirty Dan breaks clean. He's an honorable gentleman.
Tie up the collar and elbow. Oh, and Dirty Dan goes to work with it. Looks like some kind of overhand hammer lock. Torquing it down right there, putting the pressure. Shane working hard. He's going to reverse it. Steps around Dirty Dan Wilder. It's got him tied up now.
Now, how do you think all at once he gained an advantage like that? Would there be hair involved?
I think excellent training. Shane Cortez gets the hammer lock on to Dirty Dan Wilder.
Looks like Cortez
Dirty
has
Dan
got a toothache.
I don't know. He must have got his face raked or something.
No. I think he had a wisdom tooth pulled last week.
Elbow. Dirty Dan says he caught him with an elbow. Here you go, Dirty Dan invites Shane Cortez back into the center of the ring. Collar and elbow tie-up. Oh, Dirty Dan into a wrist lock, working it hard. Tightens it down, Shane Cortez obviously in a lot of pain at this point.
Ledge, that puts a lot of pressure on the wrist, the elbow, and the shoulder joint and the arm.
Exactly. This is a typical tactic of professional wrestling.
And as skinny as Cortez's arms are, they could snap and twig.
Big side leg takedown over the top of Shane Cortez. Sets him up now.
There's a front chancery by Dirty Dan Wilder.
Both wrestlers into the ropes. Referee Doug McCoy orders a hold broken, and it's a clean break. Shane Cortez ordered to a neutral corner. Both wrestlers back into the ring now, circling. Dirty Dan wants to try a test of strength with Shane Cortez.
This ought to be interesting because both men are about the same height and same weight. Be Shane, interesting to see who
Shane moves in. Here. They're setting it up easy. Oh, and Dirty Dan goes on the attack right off the bat. Shane's able to reverse it. He's got Dirty Dan Wilder in a lot of pain right now. Going to work on those hands. Oh, the fingers of Dirty
wrestling employee stomping somebody's fingers as a maneuver.
Oh, the crowd is loving it, aren't they?
You wouldn't see Dirty Dan Wilder or something like that.
Well, Dirty Dan Wilder hasn't done something like that because he hasn't had the chance. No, once again, Shane Cortez going to work on that arm. Sets up the wrist lock. Oh, Dirty Dan's got him into the ropes. Whip off the ropes. Oh!
Also, he's got the second set of eyes in Bone Crusher Bobby Burns to lend advice to him. Smart move.
You know, I can't believe how the Outlaws are busy mouthing off about Scott Summers in that interview a little while ago. Have the fitting with them in the Southern Express meet next week. There's going to be a lot of fireworks going on, but right now,
there is one thing to think about. Will Scott Summers be able to wrestle next week after the butt kicking he got courtesy of Big A?
I don't think there'll be a problem. That's one of the amazing things about professional wrestlers is that recovery rate. I don't think Scott Summers will have any trouble being ready for the match with the Texas Outlaws.
I think he put more than a week's worth of butt kicks on Scott Summers.
And Dirty Dan Wilder takes his time about entering the ring. He's back into the ring now. Oh, and down on his knees, he says he doesn't want any more of Shane Cortez, and now he's trying to call a timeout. What is this, timeout night?
Watch him, Ledge, watch him.
Unbelievable, Shane chases him into the corner. Oh, and the Texas Outlaw reverses the whip.
Dirty Dan Wilder always thinking, always thinking. Once he is, he trips and falls out of the ring.
Well, I think some of the falling after the exit from the ring had something to do with Bone Crusher Bobby Burns over there.
No, it had to do with fear of Dirty Dan Wilder. When is Cortez going to learn? He keeps biting off more than he can chew.
Nice suplex sends Cortez to the mat. He has got lower back problems now. Dirty Dan moves in with that, goes to work on that submission hold, torquing it down.
That's almost like a variation of the camel clutch. It's like a rear chin lock, putting a lot of pressure on the back of the neck.
So, yep, it's a reverse chin lock.
Forearm to the chest.
Nice boot to the midsection. Follows it up with a knee to the forehead of Shane Cortez, and now he's got him pinned on the mat.
Why is it Doug McCoy count? This is a legal pinning combination.
Well, I don't know, but we've got referee Doug McCoy in the ring to make sure that the rules are observed. Texas Outlaw really going over Shane Cortez.
Cortez is in the corner. Doug McCoy orders the break. One more time. Dirty Dan Wilder with a forearm across the head. The bridge of the nose, knowing the extremely wonderful style of Dirty Dan Wilder.
Shane Cortez reaching for the ropes, gets stopped, and now he picks up with a whip. Big clothesline, and Shane Cortez is down.
You can almost feel the concussion from that over here.
Shane Cortez taking a heck of a beating. Oh, a nice takedown by Dirty Dan Wilder. Shane Cortez is going to have a headache in the morning.
How old is Cortez? Isn't he like 13 or 14 years old?
He's like early to mid-20s, I believe.
I figure he's about 14, and keep going at this rate, he'll be retired by the time he's 17.
Shane Cortez hanging in there barely. He's in big trouble right now against the Texas Outlaw. Dirty Dan Wilder. Oh, sets him up. Oh, big brain buster sends Cortez down in the mat.
That is it. That pile driver from Dirty Dan Wilder jamming the spine down into the mat. It's done. Cortez is finished. Dirty Dan is now just taking liberties and enjoyment and
punishing. In the back of Shane Cortez, you can really see what kind of an individual Shane is. Even though he's out on the mat, he's still fighting. Oh, and it looks like Bone Crusher Bobby Burns there to get his 2 cents in this match.
Are you watching the same match I am?
I'm sure I'm watching anything. It right here.
Got him rolled up. 2 count on Dirty Dan Wilder by referee Doug McCoy. Cortez, I guess, maybe I didn't give him enough credit. He's got a little bit of resiliency.
Big boot by Shane Cortez. He's back on his feet now, and he's coming back strong after the Texas Outlaw. Goes to work on that headlock.
It's almost a sleeper hold.
Almost. If it's exerted just right, it would put him to sleep, but Shane Cortez seems intent on dishing out a little punishment. Nice leg drop by Shane Cortez, and Dirty Dan Wilder's in a heap of trouble.
Well, Cortez has got this much energy left after the pile driver Dirty Dan administered just a few minutes ago.
That's what separates professional wrestlers from amateurs, is that recovery rate. Shane Cortez on the attack now, goes in with the arm bar against Dirty Dan Wilder, putting the pressure on at the neck and at the shoulder.
Hey, shut up!
Dirty Dan is in trouble at this point. Shane Cortez doing an amazing job of reversing. Oh! Dirty Dan reaches up with the leg scissors and drags Shane Cortez over the top.
Giving him the shots to the gut. I love it. I love it. That shows you, Dirty Dan Wilder is always thinking he's a brain kind of man.
Both men have been through a lot of punishment up to this point. Shane's trying to set some up. He's trying to go for the pin. Nice move. Dirty Dan Wilder on top now. Shane Cortez reversed it. There's some of that amateur wrestling coming out, able to get the arm bar on Dirty Dan Wilder, but he faced into the mat. Shane Cortez still working on it now. Oh, and the referee's warning Dirty Dan Wilder about the hair pull right there. Dirty Dan exits the ring.
Taking a breather.
Shane Cortez did a fine job fighting back from the deadening effects of that brainbuster.
You know, I will give credit where credit is due. Cortez's amateur background style coming into play there, and his second win. I'll give him credit. A little bit.
Very good wrestler. The guy's been training, obviously working hard in the gym, showing some natural ability for professional wrestling.
Why don't you slap that ref?
Referee Doug McCoy administers the 10 count, and now Dirty Dan Wilder enters the ring once again. Tries to get Shane Cortez backed off. Shane moves in, stalking the Texas Outlaw.
What a gentleman. Even after all that, Dirty Dan is offering his hand to the man in a gesture of friendship and peace.
I can't believe it. It'll be a blow, and Shane Cortez knows it's a trick.
That shows you what kind of guy Cortez is.
He
never refuses a man's hand. Man offers his hand for a handshake. You don't refuse it. That's a gentleman.
That's why we don't shake hands with the Texas Outlaws.
No, that's what he gets for refusing it the first time.
Oh, big forearm sends Shane Cortez to the mat. Once again, going to work on the cranial area.
He's got his knee across the chin. Now he's got him in a
toe. Dirty Dan reaches in with a choke hold. The referee's ordering the hold, bro.
That's not a choke hold, Reg. It's a nerve hold.
Choking it down.
That's not a choke. It's a nerve hold. There's a pressure point on the bottom of the chin. Dirty Dan is an expert in that field.
Well, that hits some nerve of Dirty Dan to try to use that hold in front of referee Doug McCoy.
He's up.
Dirty Dan brings Shane Cortez to his feet. Double thrust, and Shane Cortez is down once again. In this angle, that looked like some sort of a heart punch or something into the chest. Another knee to the back of the head, and he drives Shane Cortez's forehead into the mat. Oh, now he's working on that pressure area right there on the back of the neck with his knee. Shane Cortez is in big trouble now. Dirty Dan Wilder taking every opportunity to inflict some damage on Shane Cortez. Reaches in with a big forearm to the chest, and Shane's in trouble on the mat, closes it up with a leg drop.
Dirty Dan Wilder has one of the most vicious leg drops in the Empire.
He adds that extra jump and that extra push down. Both the wrestlers attempt the roll-up. Small package by Shane Cortez. He's doing it again. Another two count. Good work by Shane Cortez. Oh, they're slugging it out now.
Fists are flying.
Both wrestlers frustrated over their inability to pin each other. Referee Doug McCoy moves in, warns both wrestlers. They're both trying to get to their feet.
Cortez ought to know better than to get into a fist fight with Dirty Dan Wilder. Dirty Dan is a brawler by trade.
Nice move by Shane Cortez. He's got the Texas Outlaw in trouble now. Goes in, tries to get the pin, kick out on two by Dirty Dan Wilder.
Cortez with another pinning combination. And a two count.
Either wrestler has the strength to pin the other one. I'd say these two guys are about as evenly matched as they go. Shane Cortez. Oh, and Shane Cortez goes to work on that knee.
Illegal. Ouch. Definitely an illegal use of the rope.
No more illegal than some of the chokeholds Shane Cortez has been forced to suffer through. Reaches in now. Oh, big arm drag.
High hip toss by Cortez.
Nice move as Shane goes in with the reverse chin lock. Putting the pressure on Dirty Dan Wilder.
That can easily be turned into one of two things, either a sleeper hold or a choke hold. And knowing Cortez, I think we know which one he would go with.
Referee Doug McCoy doing a good job of staying right in the middle of the action. He's had his hands full with these two guys tonight. Obviously, no love lost between Dirty Dan Wilder and Shane Cortez.
Dirty Dan's got him in a rear hammerlock. That can easily separate a shoulder or break the mid-arm joint from the forearm to the elbow.
Dirty Dan working on that arm now. Shane Cortez is in trouble. Dirty Dan brings Shane to his feet. Sets him up, whip off the ropes. Oh, nice sunset flip by. Welcome back to the World Wrestling Empire. It's been quite a night here in Sepulpa, Oklahoma. Can't believe some of the things I've seen. Rebel and Predator. It broke loose. It was nuts. Renegade come in, interfering with that match. Scott Summers and Annihilator, of course, awesome as usual. What can you say about it when those two guys go at it?
Ended up being a double disqualification, but I believe in the end, Scott Summers was the worse for wear.
No love lost between those two. And then the match you just saw, Shane Cortez taking on Dirty Dan Wilder. Shane pulling it out right at the end with some fine moves. Some of that amateur wrestling skill coming to light on that match.
And a handful of tights didn't hurt either.
Been a great match here. Been a great night here at the matches with the World Wrestling Empire. We want to take this opportunity to thank our sponsors, Dabcom Productions, Downey Tax Service,
Cintas the Uniform People,
Jernigan Graphics and Design,
Gabe's Office Supply,
Golden Reflections Rock and Roll,
Try Us for Insurance,
Cyber Graphics Custom Screen Printings,
and of course Sean Bynum, Shauna Rose Photography,
and also Still Fox Sound Company. Also want to thank the WWE directory staff, Michael Hunt and Richard Head, the executive officers.
The administrative director is Cindy Downey.
And David Jernigan for marketing and advertising coordination.
And of course, if you'd like to mail cards, letters, or get on the World Wrestling Empire mailing list, you can write to the World Wrestling Empire, Post Office Box 93, Owosso, Oklahoma, 74055.
All right, for the World Wrestling Empire, I'm the Ledge with Devlin Blanchard. Don't forget, next week, same time, same place, this is the World Wrestling Empire. Good night, Kayla. Have a good one.
The difference is obvious.
I'll be quiet. copy of tonight's show, send $19.95 plus $3 shipping and handling to the World Wrestling Empire, P.O. Box 593, Owosso, Oklahoma, 74055. Or if you'd like to be notified of upcoming events, just write the World Wrestling Empire, P.O. Box 593, Owosso, Oklahoma, 74055.